Lekki massacres. How governor ordered Operation Mesa to kill NSAS protesters. Lagos Democratic Coalition. Hello everyone. Welcome back to Greenfield Media. We want to thank you specially for always coming out to listen to us. May God continue to bless you. Please like this post and share with your friends and subscribe too. Let us know what you think about the story in the comment section. So, the governor of Lagos State has been accused by the Lagos Democratic Coalition for ordering the soldiers to kill NSAS protesters, something they call Operation Mesa. So let's know what really happened according to the Lagos Democratic Coalition. A civil society organization, Lagos Democratic Coalition, has revealed that the soldiers who carried out the killing and maiming of unarmed protesters at Lekki Tollgate were members of Operation Mesa in Lagos State. The coalition said, contrary to the denial by the Lagos State governor, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, on his involvement in the shooting of the protesters on the 22nd of October 2020, he actually ordered the operation. The coalition, in a statement signed by Henry Ojubana Esquire, its Secretary General and comrade Senami Ojikutu, convener, made available to journalists on Sunday, went on to explain that the governor has complete control over this security outfit and the RRS, that is the Rapid Response Squad, as the chairman of the Lagos State Security Council that comprised the Commissioner of Police of Lagos State Command and the commander of the 9th Brigade of the Nigerian Army and the director of the State Security Service in Lagos, as well as heads of the Navy, Air Force, FRSC, Civil Defense, and LASMA. The Operation Mesa is a joint internal security outfit comprising military personnel drawn from the Army, Navy, and Air Force, and set up by the Nigerian military in 2008 to complement the efforts of the police in fighting violent crimes in Lagos State and as well as other states. The Lagos Democratic Coalition said the governor's order to violently dislodge peaceful protesters from the Lekki toll gates with lethal force was carried out by and in conjunction with the command instruction to the coordinator of OP Mesa by the commander of the 9th Brigade of the Nigerian Army, Brigadier General Musa A. Etsu Dagi, allegedly without prior notice to or approval from the military authorities, as well as ACP Tunji Jusi, the commander of RRS. The group said that whilst the total number of persons killed in the state-sponsored shootings is yet to be ascertained, I quote, "We are aware not less than 12 persons have been confirmed to have died from the fatal shooting and may have been confirmed to have been fatally shot during the carnage, some of whom do not have access to or and cannot afford medical treatment." This is the same number of persons that Amnesty International was saying died too. 12. It's been consistent with that Amnesty figures too. I quote the statement from the Lagos Democratic Coalition. "It is mind-boggling that Sanwo-Olu would order the killing and maiming of the very citizen he swore an oath and has a constitutional duty to protect. It is indeed a sad irony that the protesters gathered at the Lekki toll gate to protest against police brutality and bad governance in the country only to be slain and maimed by their own governor. We know that the blockage of the Lekki toll gate by the protesters caused significant financial loss to the governor's godfather and benefactor, who is known to have a controlling financial interest in Lekki Concession Company, the operators and concessionaires of the Lekki toll road. Nonetheless, the flouting of curfew as well as temporary and minor injury to the financial interest of the governor's godfather does not warrant and cannot justify the use of lethal and deadly force against unarmed protesters by Governor Sanwo-Olu and his military and political collaborators. Governor Sanwo-Olu's inconsistent, conflicting, and unintelligible explanations bear implausible deniers with respect to who deployed the soldiers, snipers and other policemen to the scene of a protest. We dare to say the governor has been speaking half-truth on this matter, and such, there are questions begging for answers. Why the soldiers and the police were deployed when the curfew declared by the governor was yet to commence? Why the governor had already imposed a curfew when there was a relative calm in the state and without adequate prior notice? Why the CCTV cameras mounted at the toll gate were dismantled shortly before the shootings began, and why the lighting and street lights at the center at the scene of the protest were switched off shortly before the soldiers and armed policemen arrived at the scene of the protest and began shooting at protesters that were babbling of a guilty man trying to absolve himself of the heinous crimes he knows the full well that he's guilty of. The governor's promise to investigate the killing and maiming of unarmed protesters at the Lekki toll gate will be an exercise in self-deceit. As those injured and slain at Lekki toll gate at the behest of Governor Sanwo-Olu and their distraught families, all Lagosians are victims of Sanwo-Olu's misguided and callous decision to attack unarmed protesters with lethal and deadly force. Our offices, houses, warehouses, and shops have been looted and burned to the ground. Our lives, livelihood, businesses have been grounded. Our streets and public spaces are burning, unsafe, polluted, and have been taken over by criminals and hoodlums. Public institutions, facilities, and buildings which offer essential services, courts, police stations, prisons, mass transit buses, government offices, banks, shopping malls, bridges and roads have either been destroyed or razed to the ground. Even our traditional institutions such as the Palace of the Oba of Lagos were not spared. The destruction of the Oba's palace is without a doubt a sad consequence of the governor's reckless judgment and callous disregard for human life, though the Oba of Lagos is unabashedly tainted politically and disconnected with the people that the youth of his kingdom did not rise in defense of their monarch's throne and palace. We call upon Governor Sanwo-Olu to own up to his involvement and responsibility for the death and fatal shooting for the death and fatal injury of patriotic, unarmed, and innocent Nigerians who are protesting and fighting for a better Nigeria to the good people of Lagos State. We also demand that an independent panel of inquiry be set up by the federal government to investigate the killing and maiming of our compatriots for simply exercising their constitutional rights to protest. Given his culpability for the death and fatal shooting of protesters, Governor Sanwo-Olu's promised panel of inquiry on the Lekki massacre will be nothing but a shambolic exercise designed to mislead the Lagosians and will be independent of the government of Lagos State and its governor, who is himself complicit and implicated in the killing and fatal shooting of protesters. We demand an independent panel of inquiry that will be led by the Nigerian Bar Association and the Nigerian Labour Congress, with public hearings as modus operandi, as anything short of this will be tantamount to a charade and journey to nowhere. This is the Lagos Democratic Coalition coming out with a lot of strong points and somewhat subjective views on what happened at the Lekki toll gate. They have a lot of good points though, but without hard evidence, all of this is just hearsay. Most of the what they're saying is alleged. There's no concrete proof. But they've managed to weave together a bunch of facts and some not so, factual utterances or statements to make their point. So at this juncture, we can't really say, okay, this is the thing, this is what really happened. And the Lagos Democratic Coalition, as they call themselves, is not an authority on any of this. Let's just state that for the fact. So we just want to put this out here to hear your thoughts on what this LDC front has to say about the whole thing. The fact that they are saying that Lagos State Governor is the chief security officer of the state, that is a fact, yes. They also allege that he chairs the Security Council of the state that comprises of the head of the police, the rapid response squad, a certain operational outfit of the Nigerian military called Operation MESA, and some other smaller agencies that the governor heads, that that security outfit in the state, and is the chief security officer in the state. All these are facts. So now, linking it to the Lekki massacres, with the cameras being removed, light being turned off, they are saying everything should be blamed on the governor. So over the last couple of days, Sanwo-Olu has been coming out to say this and say that. He's always contradicting himself. So it wasn't too long before somebody would point all of this out. So the Lagos Democratic Coalition has said this is what happens. So they have a lot of points though. So let's hear what you think about it in the comment section. Is the governor in control of Operation MESA? Is he really the chief security officer of the state? Of course he is. So let us hear your thoughts on this in the comment section. Thank you for listening to us. God bless you.